Second session, we are started the in the first session we are discussed about the course contents, ATLP related to the ATLP and course web and the COPOs. So we have seen. So now we'll go into the details of the course. So our course code is U18CE503. U18CE503. Course name is Structural Analysis. So this is the fifth semester course. So this is the unit one. In this unit one, we'll discuss about the slope deflection method of analysis of structures. The first chapter we're going to deal about the beams, and in the second chapter, that is unit two, second chapter, we'll discuss about frames, so analysis of frames by using slope deflection method. So before going to into the slope deflection method of analysis, so we require some specific knowledge about static indeterminacy and the kinematic indeterminacy, and we require some terminology. So what is static indeterminacy, what is kinematic indeterminacy, what is determinate structure, what is determinate structure and what is indeterminate structure, what is stable structure, what is unstable structure, what is mechanism. So those things we need to learn before going into the course curriculum. So can anyone tell me what is a stable structure? Do you know what is stable structure, students? So do you know this terminology, static indeterminacy, kinematic indeterminacy, degree of static indeterminacy, determinate structure, indeterminate structure? Have you heard these words anywhere? Students? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. You can tell me what is determinate structure? What is determinate structure? What is determinate structure and what is indeterminate structure?
If all the equilibrium equations are satisfied within a structure, it is called a determinate structure.
Okay, okay. So if the equilibrium equations are sufficient to on a complete analysis of the structure, for analyzing the structure completely, only static equilibrium equations are sufficient, then the structure is called statically determinate structure. So what are the equilibrium equations? What are the equilibrium equations? So equilibrium equations are for the plane frame. So equilibrium equations are summation of forces in the x direction must be equal to zero. Summation of forces in y direction, it will be equal to zero. Summation of moments at a particular joint must be equal to zero. So these are the three fundamental equilibrium equations. If the three fundamental equilibrium equations are enough to solve that particular structure or element, that structure or element is called statically determinate structure or element. Okay, so let us suppose I want to take a simply supported beam. I want to take a simply supported beam. So I'm going to ask you whether this is a statically determinate structure or indeterminate structure. Can anyone tell me whether it is a statically determinate structure or indeterminate structure? So for analyzing the structure, let us suppose I'll give load also, 50 kilonewton load. So it is possible to analyze this simply supported beam by using this equation. For analyzing the simply supported beam for the given loading, these equations are sufficient, or any other any external conditions are required, or compatibility conditions are required. So what is meant by analyzing this analysis of simply supported beam for the given load? If it is, it can be analyzed by using this equilibrium equation, then it is called statically determinate structure. So simply supported beam is a statically determinate structure. How can we are saying that? Let's note. So here the unknowns are the reactions, unknown reactions. So unknowns are the, in simply supported beam, unknowns are the reactions. One horizontal reaction, two vertical reactions. So these, if you calculate these reactions, we need to calculate these reactions. That is nothing but analysis. So analysis and entity calculation of horizontal reactions as well as vertical reactions in a simply supported beam, then it is called the analysis. Okay. So by using these equations, we can able to solve. So here three unknowns is there. We have three equations. So three equations and three unknowns. So number of equations, number of unknowns must be equal to number of equations. So it is satisfying. It is related to the mathematical equation. So let us suppose ax square plus bx plus c. So here the unknown is only one unknown. Ax plus by is equal to c. Here are the two unknowns. So for solving these two unknowns, we require two equations. Got three unknowns. Three equations are required. So three equilibrium equations are sufficient to solve this simply supported beam. So this is a statically determined structure. So simply, so we can say that we can calculate whether the statically indeterminate or determinate by using some simple formulas. M plus R minus 2J. So from this formula also we can able to calculate whether the statically determinate structure or statically indeterminate structure, so that we can able to calculate. So the thing you need to understand is the statically determinate structure is a structure we can analyze by using static equilibrium equations alone. Only static equilibrium equations use complete structure and complete analyze cheyagalugute, the structure is called statically determinate structure. What is indeterminate structure then? If the structure is not able to analyze completely by using static equilibrium equations alone, so additional compatibility equation or additional equations are required to complete analysis of the structure, then it is called statically indeterminate or kinematically indeterminate structure. Okay, so that is the difference between determinate structure and indeterminate structure. So determinate structure manam we can analyze using equilibrium equation, sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, and moment at a particular joint must be equal to 0. Summation of moments at particular joint equal to 0. Summation of forces in x direction equal to 0. Summation of forces in y direction equal to 0. By using these three equations, if you solve that structure, then it is called determinate structure. If you are not able to solve that structure by using these three equilibrium equation, then it is called indeterminate structure. Okay, right. So this is about the determinate structure and indeterminate structure. You can mute your mic, students. If you mute your mic. Yeah, we will discuss about first. So just now we are discussing about determinate structure and indeterminate structure. What is determinate structure? Just now we are discussing. If we solve the equation, they solve the structure by using the equilibrium equations only. Equilibrium equations can you just solve yes then mano determinant structure anukunnamo. If you are along with this equilibrium equation additional compatibility conditions or compatibility equations can you just solve yes then that is called along with this equilibrium equations fx is equal to 0 sigma fi is equal to 0 and the summation of moments at equal to 0 and theta at a equal to 0 and delta at a equal to 0 something like this. So additional compatibility equations also are also needed to complete analysis of structure, then it is called statically indeterminate structure. So determinate structure and indeterminate structure. So there is a difference between determinate structure and indeterminate structure. So this indeterminate structures again divide into two categories. Indeterminate structures again categorized into two categories. First one is statical degree statically indeterminate structure, kinematically indeterminate structure. So static indeterminate structure, kinematic indeterminate structure. So we need to calculate the for the structure. For analyzing indeterminate structures, I hope you understood what is indeterminate structure. For analyzing indeterminate structure, we need to calculate static indeterminacy. We need to calculate kinematic indeterminacy. Static indeterminacy we need to calculate as well as kinematic indeterminacy we need to calculate. If static indeterminacy of the structure is less as compared to kinematic indeterminacy of the structure, the static indeterminacy is less as compared to kinematic indeterminacy of the structure, then we can go use force methods. If kinematic indeterminacy of the structure is less than the static indeterminacy, then we can use displacement method. Okay, I hope you understood. Meeku ardhamaindi anukuntunna. So manam ippudu em nechukunamo, what is, yeah, okay, I'll repeat once again students. So students, are you got an idea about determinate structure? Feel free. So determinate structure ante ardham endandi, what is determinate structure?
Yes sir.
Yeah, determinate structure ante ardham endi, indeterminate structure ante ardham enda?
Yes sir.
So indeterminate structure ante we cannot, let us suppose I'll draw one indeterminate structure. So this is a fixed beam. So for the fixed beam, so what are the unknowns for the fixed beam? The unknowns for the fixed beam are two horizontal reactions for the given loading. I'll give one load and one moment. So external load, supplied load is 100 kilonewton and 50 kilonewton meter is a moment. Two moments, one force and one moment is acting here. So for this, the unknowns are two vertical reactions, two horizontal reaction, and one moment reaction at one support, another moment reaction at another support, moment at B and moment at A. So these are the six unknowns here. So six unknowns unnayandi, but for analyzing a plane structure we have three equilibrium equations is there. What are they? Sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, summation of moments at any joint must be equal to 0. So these three equations is there, but we have six unknowns is there. So we cannot able to analyze the structure by using only this equilibrium equations use manamu solve cheyalem. Vidiki em kavali, additional compatibility equations are required for complete analysis of the structure. What are the additional compatibility equations? Em untayandi, for a fixed support at a, delta a must be equal to 0. Ikkada settle avadu kada, and settlement should be 0, and rotation at a is also 0. So if we use additional compatibility equations other than the equilibrium equation for complete analysis of the structure, then the structure is called ఇన్డిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్. సో డిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్కి ఇన్డిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్కి మనకు డిఫరెన్స్ అనేది అర్థమైందని అనుకుంటున్నాను నేను. ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ డిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్ అండ్ ఇండిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్? ఓకే రైట్. సో సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్, రిమెంబర్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ ఈజ్ ఏ డిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్, ఫిక్స్డ్ బీమ్ ఈజ్ ఏ ఇండిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్. రైట్, విల్ మూవ్ ఫార్వర్డ్. సో హియర్ whether it is a determinate structure or indeterminate structure, it is depends upon its indeterminacy, degree of indeterminacy meda depend avutadi whether it is determinate structure or indeterminate. So for this determinate structure or indeterminate structure, it is depends upon indeterminacy of the structure. Let us suppose for the simply supported beam undandi. ఫర్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ ఇన్డిటర్మినసీ ఈజ్ జీరో, అంటే ఇన్డిటర్మినసీ ఈజ్ జీరో, జస్ట్ రిమెంబర్ ఇట్. తర్వాత నేను దాని గురించి వచ్చినప్పుడు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తాను క్లియర్గా. ఫర్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ ఇన్డిటర్మినసీ ఈజ్ జీరో అంటే మన దాని మీనింగ్ ఏంటంటే వీఆర్ సాల్వింగ్ దిస్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ ఓన్లీ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం ఈక్వేషన్ యూజ్ చేసుకొని మనం సాల్వ్ చేస్తున్నాం. సో దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్డిటర్మినసీ ఫర్ దిస్ స్టాటిక్ ఇన్డిటర్మినసీ ఫర్ దిస్ for simply supported beam is zero. Same for the fixed beam. For the fixed beam indeterminacy is 3, indeterminacy is 3 endukante manaki actually ga 6 unknowns unnai ikkada manaki. For fixed beam we have 6 unknowns but we have only 3 equilibrium equations unnai ga kabatti the indeterminacy for this fixed beam is 3. For this if you compare simply supported beam, the number of unknowns in the simply supported beam, here we have 3, one roller support and one hinged support. So hinged support daggara rendu reactions untayandi, roller support daggara one horizontal vertical reaction will be there. So number of unknowns for the simply supported beam is 3, number of equilibrium equations is also 3. So 3 minus 3 equal to 0. So indeterminacy for the simply supported beam is 0, indeterminacy for fixed beam it is 3. So we need to calculate whether it is a determinate structure or indeterminate structure. Define chestunnappudu what we need to do is we need to calculate the degree of indeterminacy of the structure. So degree of indeterminacy of the structure ni manam identify cheyali. So here the indeterminacy is two types. Indeterminacy is two types, whether it is a statically indeterminate or kinematic indeterminate. So that means we need to calculate static indeterminacy of the structure as well as kinematic indeterminacy of the structure. So indeterminacy is two types. First one is static and second one is kinematic. Okay, so depending upon the static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy, we'll going to use suitable method of analysis. Whether it, depending upon static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy, we'll going to choose different methods. So we have different methods of analysis. So mana syllabus lo em undandi slope deflection method of analysis undi, mana first chuste slope deflection method an undandi, adhe vidhanga moment distribution method untadi, Kanis method untadandi, next stiffness methods untayi. So so many methods is there. So depending upon suitable, so depending upon its indeterminacy, whether static indeterminacy kinematic indeterminacy based iskoni, we'll going to select the suitable methods. Students, is it clear for you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Respond, students.
Yes, sir.
So indeterminacy is two type, static indeterminacy, kinematic indeterminacy. దీని బట్టి మనం ఏం చేస్తాం అంటే suitable method we'll going to select. So in our curriculum, so for analyzing indeterminate structures, we will use different methods. Analyzing determinate structures, we'll directly we can able to solve. Manam by using equilibrium equations, we can able to solve. We can able to analyze. Okay, we can able to analyze simply by using the equilibrium equations. We can complete analyze. We can able to analyze completely deterministic structure, but it is not possible to analyze completely for indeterminate structure. ఈ ఇండిటర్మినేట్ స్ట్రక్చర్ అనలైజ్ చేయాలంటే మనం ఏం చేస్తాం అంటే డిఫరెంట్ మెథడ్స్ ఫాలో అవుతాం. స్లోప్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ మెథడ్ యూజ్ చేస్తాము, మూమెంట్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ మెథడ్ ఫాలో అవుతాము, కానిస్ మెథడ్ ఫాలో అవుతాము. వి హావ్ లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ డిఫరెంట్ మెథడ్స్ వి హావ్. ఐల్ షో యూ ది లిస్ట్. మూమెంట్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ డిఫార్మేషన్ మెథడ్ థియరమ్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ వర్క్ కాలమ్ అనాలజీ మెథడ్ ఫ్లెక్సిబిలిటీ మ్యాట్రిక్స్ మెథడ్ స్లోప్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ మెథడ్ మూమెంట్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ మెథడ్ కానిస్ మెథడ్ స్టిఫ్నెస్ మ్యాట్రిక్స్ మెథడ్. సో వి హావ్ different list of methods. So by using these methods we can able to analyze static statically indeterminate structure. So statically indeterminate structure ni solve cheyalante analyze cheyalante we can use any of these methods, any one of these methods. So ee method lo edho oka method use chesukoni manam solve cheskochu. We can analyze the structure, but the complexity of the problem is different from one method to another method. ee method use chesukonanna manam solve cheskochu manam statically indeterminate structure ni. ఈ మెథడ్ ఈ మెథడ్స్లో ఏదైనా ఒక మెథడ్ యూజ్ చేసుకొని మనం సాల్వ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. బట్ ద థింగ్ ఈస్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ మెథడ్ టు అనదర్ మెథడ్. సో మరి ఏ మెథడ్ మనం ఎట్లా సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకోవాలి అంటే ఇట్ ఈస్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ఇండిటర్మినసీ ఆఫ్ ద స్ట్రక్చర్. ఏ మెథడ్ని ఫాలో కావాలనేది దీని మీద డిపెండ్ అవుతుంది. అంటే ఇట్ ఈస్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ది ఇండిటర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ డిగ్రీ ఆఫ్ ఇండిటర్మినసీ ఆఫ్ ద స్ట్రక్చర్. ఇఫ్ స్టాటిక్ ఇండిటర్మినసీ ఈస్ లెస్ యాజ్ compared to kinematic indeterminacy. Kinematic ante entante displacement, it is related to the displacements. Static ante it is related to the forces. Okay, vela static indeterminacy ganka takku unte we will use force method. If the kinematic indeterminacy is less, we will use displacement methods. Kinematic indeterminacy takku unte we will use displacement methods. Static indeterminacy takku unte we will use force method. So we'll see what are the force methods and what are the displacement methods. So force method here, method of consistent deformation, theorem of least work, column analysis method, flexibility matrix method. So if static indeterminacy ganaka takkunte we will use these methods. If the kinematic indeterminacy is less as compared to static indeterminacy, then we will use these methods. If both are same, static indeterminacy kinematic indeterminacy same ఉన్నాయి అనుకోండి, యూ కెన్ యూస్ ఈ సిక్స్ మెథడ్స్ లో ఎయిట్ మెథడ్స్ లో ఏ మెథడ్ అని యూజ్ చేసుకొని యూ కెన్ అనలైజ్ ద స్ట్రక్చర్. ఓకే రైట్, ఐ హోప్ యూ అండర్స్టూడ్ స్టూడెంట్స్. వన్ స్టూడెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ గర్ల్స్ సైడ్ యూ కెన్ రెస్పాండ్. Is it clear for you, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So if you have any doubt or anything, you can immediately you can ask. Okay? So students, I'm recording this video and I'm going to post this video in the YouTube. I'll share this link in your course web. You can once again, you can go through it. If you have any doubts, you can even contact us. Okay? Right. So first we will discuss about, so we have kinematic, two types of indeterminacy. First one is kinematic indeterminacy, static indeterminacy. So first, so our method is, in our curriculum, first unit is slope deflection method. So slope deflection method is related to kinematic indeterminacy. We will discuss about the kinematic indeterminacy first. After that, we're going to see the static indeterminacy also. So kinematic indeterminacy is nothing but it is related to the displacements. Kinematic indeterminacy is nothing but it is related to the displacements. So here the degree of freedom, this is also called degree of freedom. Kinematic indeterminacy is also called the degree of freedom. So whatever I am explaining here, the static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy calculations, those are very very important for your competitive examinations. So try to focus on this static indeterminacy calculation and kinematic indeterminacy calculations. Very, very, very important for your competitive examination. Students, you need to focus on these two. So if you compulsory one or two questions in the gate examination. So gate examination lo main ga focus is structure analysis lo main ga focus chesedi entante static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy gate exam or IAS examinations. So competitive examinations lo very very important. So try to focus. So I'll going to explain more number of problems in your tutorial class. So I'll going to solve one or two problems here, but I'll going to solve more number of questions in the tutorial session. So try to focus on this kinematic indeterminacy and static indeterminacy, right? So kinematic indeterminacy is also called the degree of freedom. Degree of freedom is also called kinematic indeterminacy. So what is kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom attained? It is the number of independent component of joint displacements. Number of independent components of the joint displacement is called the kinematic indeterminacy. Kinematic indeterminacy is nothing but number of joint displacements. So number of joint displacements is called nothing but, let us suppose oka joint undandi, joint daggara enni displacements unnai, that number is nothing but it's a kinematic indeterminacy. Number of joint independent joint displacements, independent joint displacements is nothing but our kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom. So displacements ante entandi, so displacements is nothing but independent rotations and deflections, rotation and deflection, delta and theta, independent rotations, rotation on theta, and this is also called dy by dx, this is also called y. So displacement is called deflection and rotation. So number of independent joint displacements is nothing but our kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom of the structure. Students, any number unnai mana count cheskovali, theta lu enni unnai, theta lu enni unknowns unnai ikkada, theta lu ikkada, let us suppose fixed support undandi, for a fixed support can anyone tell me rotation, let us suppose this is support A anukuntunna, for a fixed support how many rotation, unknown rotations and unknown displacements will be there for a fixed support? Students, you can respond. For the fixed support, how many unknown rotations and displacements will be there?
3, sir.
For the fixed, students, is it 3? Wrong. Unknown reactions is 3. Students, unknown reactions is 3. But what I am asking, unknown displacements. Here I am telling you unknown displacements. Very good. Zero. So unknown reaction. So manamo mechanics of materials gaani strength of material mana entadi engineering mechanics lo manam em nechukunnamo reactions gurinchi nechukunnamandi, vertical reaction, horizontal reaction, moment reaction at A, let us suppose this is A, then the unknown reactions is 3. So that is static indeterminacy. Static indeterminacy will be number of unknowns minus equilibrium equations is nothing but static indeterminacy. So that is number of unknowns for the fixed support is 3. So number of displacements for this fixed support, ikkada chudandi em unde chance untadandi, a kabatti ikkada rotation vache chance untadi theta a. ఇది కిందికి వెళ్ళే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది, పక్కకి వెళ్ళే డెల్టా ఏ, డెల్టా ఎక్స్ ఉంటుందండి, డెల్టా వై ఉంటుందండి. సో డెల్టా టీటా ఉండొచ్చు, టీటా ఏ ఉండొచ్చు, డెల్టా ఎక్స్ ఉండే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది, డెల్టా వై ఉంటుంది. బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ఫిక్స్డ్, ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ సెటిల్. సో డెల్టా ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0, డెల్టా వై ఈక్వల్ టు 0, ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ రొటేట్ ఎనీ హౌ. సో ది డిఫార్మ్డ్ షేప్ ఆఫ్ ఫర్ ది ఫిక్స్డ్ సపోర్ట్, ద డిఫార్మ్డ్ షేప్ ఆఫ్ ది బీమ్ విల్ బి సంథింగ్ లైక్ దిస్. సో ఇట్ విల్ deformed shape is something like this. So here the rotation is also 0 at a fixed end. So theta a is equal to 0 and delta x is equal to 0, delta y is also 0. So total it is, so kinematic inertness for the fixed support is 0. Okay. So, but unknown reactions is 3. Unknown reactions is 3. Unknown displacements is 0. Unknown reactions is 3 and unknown displacements is 0. Students, is it clear for you, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. We'll move forward then. So similarly, I'll show you some different supports for fixed support. Just now we have seen for the fixed support, degree of freedom is 0. So DOF is nothing but degree of freedom. So degree of freedom is 0. That is theta A is equal to 0. The delta is also 0. So for the fixed support is 0. Next, coming to pinned support. So let us suppose I'll show you pinned support. So deformed shape of the, let us suppose I'll take a simply supported beam. For the pinned support, here this is pinned support and this is the roller support. So deformed shape of the structure is, this is the deformed shape. Here theta will be there. Here is also theta will be there. Here it may displace in x direction. Displace in x direction. ఎందుకంటే ఇక్కడ చూడండి ఇట్లా హారిజాంటల్గా మూవ్ అవ్వడానికి ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది. రోలర్స్ ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ హారిజాంటల్గా మూవ్ అవ్వదు, డిస్ప్లేస్ అవ్వదు, వర్టికల్ కూడా డిస్ప్లేస్ అవ్వదు. బట్ ఓన్లీ రొటేషన్ ఈస్ పాసిబుల్ ఫర్ ది హింజర్డ్ సపోర్ట్. ఫర్ ది హింజర్డ్ సపోర్ట్ రొటేషన్ మే టేక్స్ ప్లేస్. బట్ రోలర్ సపోర్ట్ అ మెంబో మే రొటేట్ అండ్ ది సపోర్ట్ మే ట్రై టు మూవ్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ ఇట్స్ ఒరిజినల్ పొజిషన్. సో ఫర్ హింజర్డ్ సపోర్ట్ వన్ రొటేషన్ విల్ బి దేర్. సో టీటా ఏ విల్ బి దేర్, టీటా ఏ అన్నోన్, delta a is 0 endukante settle avatledu kabatti displacement is 0, rotation will be there for the hinged support. If you take roller support so this is roller support. For the roller support theta b is unknown and displacement in x direction is unknown, displacement in y direction is 0. Y direction la displacement undadandi, this is 0 and x direction la displacement will be there, that is unknown, and rotation is also unknown, we don't know the rotation at b, so that is also unknown. So number of unknown independent unknown displacements is 2. Number of independent displacement at for the roller support it is 2. So one rotation, one displacement. Students, you got this point? Okay, right. Next, for so this type of support, vertical shear release support. So loads will act on this. So whatever the load, applied load will transfer like this. So there will be not deformation for this member. So deformation under the gravity, theta will be equal to 0 only. Delta y will be there, so delta y will be unknown. So for the vertical shear release support, the unknown is 1. For horizontal release support, so this is the horizontal shear release support. So this only translation will be there, moment will not be there. So theta is equal to 0, so delta x will be there. So delta x is the only unknown. Chudandi ee type of support ki chala difference undani. So this is the roller support and this will be the shear release support. This is also roller, but this is called shear release support. So these are the two different supports. Okay, make a note of this. Okay, so for the supports, different supports, the unknown displacements or degree of freedom is we are seeing. So for fixed support 0, for hinged support 1. మీరు గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి, మీరు ట్రై టు రిమెంబర్, మీకు ఇది అర్థమైనా అర్థం కాకపోయినా గుర్తుపెట్టుకొని ట్రై చేయండి. ఫర్ ఫిక్స్డ్ సపోర్ట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ 0, ఫర్ హింజెడ్ సపోర్ట్ ఇస్ 1, ఫర్ రోలర్ సపోర్ట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ 2. ఓకే, ఫర్ వర్టికల్ షియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ 1, For horizontal shear, it is 1. Degree of freedom is 1. Okay. Next, for different joints. So now we have seen the supports. We'll see joints. Can anyone tell me what is the difference between joint and support? So let us suppose I'll show you one simple structure. So this is A and this is B and this is C. So A, B are called the support, C will be the joint. Friends, are you getting my point or not? So C is a support. Sorry, C is a joint. A and B are the support. So load is transferring from the supports to column or something. But whatever the load coming onto the joint has to transfer to the support. So it is the joint, this is the joint, and these are the two supports. So hinged support, roller support, this is the joint. So for the joint, so for this joint also, there will be a joint displacements will be there. So that joint displacements we need to calculate. So we need to calculate number of independent joint displacement. That is also degree of freedom. That is also we need to calculate. So for the roller hinged support, the displacement will be 1. Degree DOF is equal to 1. For roller support, it is 2. For this, that we need to calculate. Okay. So we'll see how we're going to calculate for the typical joints. For this type of joint, so three members are meeting here. Three members are meeting. So let us suppose here three members are meeting. So this is a fixed joint. Let us suppose fixed joint, and that is a rotation is a displacement is as a whole, it will displace. As a whole, it will rotate. And okay, a member rotate just automatically. Any members load same amount of rotation will be there. Okay. So for this type of joint, let us suppose it is a rigid joint. This is called a rigid joint. For the rigid joint, the DOF will be equal to 3. For the rigid joint, degree of freedom is equal to 3. We will see. So anyhow, for the rigid joint, theta for the three individual members is same. Whatever the theta will going to apply for the rigid joint, the same amount of rotation will also take place. So I'll draw the displaced shape of the structure joint. So this is let us theta C, theta B, and theta A. For this rigid joint, theta A, theta B, theta C is same. So the number of unknown rotational components, unknown rotational components is only 1, that is theta. This type of only rotation okate untadandi. Unknowns okate untadi. Kabatti this is 1. And delta X will be there and delta Y will be also there. So delta X untadandi, delta Y untadi. So number of unknowns for the rigid joint is 3. Theta is same for all the members. So unknown is only theta, delta X and delta Y. So total number of degree of freedom for this type of typical joint is 3. Next, one hinge provided at one member. Oka member matrame hinge undandi. Ikkada matrame hinge undi. Ee rendu members ki hinge tho sambandham ledhu, connection ledhu. So for that, ee two members ki oka rotation untadi, ee member ki inko rotation untadi. So theta A equal to theta B. And is not equal to theta C. So unknowns rotations is theta A and theta C. Rendu unknown rotations unnayandi. Displacements as usual, delta X, delta Y. Okay. So two number of rotations. Theta A, let us suppose this is, I'll show you here. Friends, are you getting my point or not? Ardham avutundandi?
Yes, sir.
Problem chestunnappudu easy ardham problem em ledhu meeku solution ante mana question chestunnappudu meeku ardham ayipothadi. So this is a introductory class. right? I'll show you one simple figure for you. So here hinge will be there. Let us suppose this is a joint is A, and this is B, and this is C, and this is D. This is theta AC for this member. For this, here theta will be there. That is theta AB. For this, theta will be there. That is theta AD. If you observe, so this is only one member, single member. This member, mana rotate just automatically. Member will rotate out. That means the rotation for the AC member and AD member is same. So theta AD AC will be equal to theta AD. But so this is the individual member. Here it is hinge will be there. Hinge will not allow the same amount of rotation for this member also. So it is not equal to theta AB for this member. Now the number of unknowns rotations is theta AC and theta AB. And rendu same ga idu anukunte automatically idu kuda anukunnatte kada. So theta AC and theta AB. So number of unknown rotations is 2. Unknown displacements, x direction la displace avochu, y direction la displace avochu kabatti delta x and delta y. So total number of unknown, total number of unknown displacements is 2 rotations and 2 displacement or translations. So total number of DOF for this type of hinge is 4. Similarly for this hinge, ee hinge kuda nenu explain chestanu. I'll explain here this type of hinge also. Right. So three individual members, they are meeting at a hinged joint. If you rotate this member, let us suppose if you rotate one member, correct member ni rotate chestunna, idi A, idi B, idi C, idi D. Oka AD member ni rotate chestunna ee direction lo, BC AB member, BC AC member lo rotate avvandi, endukante this is a individual member, here hinge will be there. Okay, so theta AD is different. If you apply movement here for this all, theta AD is different, theta AC is different, theta AB is also different. They are not equal. So the number of unknown rotations for this type of joint is 3 rotations and 2 displacement. So total here displace unknown displacements is 5. 5 number of displacement will be there. Okay, so this type of one is delta x, delta x, delta y. 3 rotation, theta AC, theta AB, theta AD. So 3 rotations and 2 translations. So for this type of joint, so these are the unknown displacements. So this type of link, so this is called a link. For this type of link, so 2 horizontal delta x for this member, delta x for this member, rendu individual members and rendu connect avvaledu, individual displacements will be there in x direction. Ee x direction la rendu displacements untai ee particular link ki. Y direction lo oka displacement untadi, one rotation will be there. So theta is theta as a joint, okati untadandi, delta x here for this member, delta x for this member, and delta y for this member. So total number is 4 number of unknown displacements So two numbers of delta x, one delta y, and one rotation at the internal link. So for the this type of link, ఈ రెండు ఇండివిజువల్ ఉన్నాయండి, రెండు వర్టికల్ డెల్టా వైలు ఉంటాయి, డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ టూ డెల్టా వై, ఫోర్ దిస్ మెంబర్ ఇస్ వన్ డెల్టా వై, ఫోర్ దిస్ మెంబర్ ఇస్ వన్ డెల్టా వై, వన్ హారిజంటల్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్, వన్ రొటేషన్ విల్ బి దేర్. సో టోటల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫోర్ నెంబర్. సో ఇవి కొన్ని కాంప్లెక్స్ అండి. ఇట్లాంటివి ఏంటంటే కొన్ని కాంప్లెక్స్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్లో అడుగుతారండి, లైక్ ఐఏఎస్ గేట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఎగ్జామ్స్లో ఇట్లాంటి కాంప్లెక్సిటీ ప్రొవైడ్ ఇస్తాడండి. సో దే మే ఆస్క్ ఇట్లాంటి క్వశ్చన్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు టూ మార్క్స్ అడుగుతూ ఉంటాడు. ఓకే రైట్. సో వి కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు సాల్వ్ ది గివెన్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ బై దిస్ మెథడ్, ఆర్ వి కెన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ వి కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా. సో ఫార్ములా, ఫార్ములేటిక్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ ఆఫ్ కైనమెటిక్ ఇండిటెన్సీ ఈజ్ డికే ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 3J-R. దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఫార్ములా ఫర్ రిజిడ్ జాయింటెడ్ structures considering axial strains also. So let us suppose, what is axial strain? Can anyone tell me? Students, just calculate the degree of freedom for this given structure. Students, calculate and tell me. For simply supported beam, what is the DOF? Students, you can tell me, calculate and tell me. So this is the roller support, this is the roller support, and this is the hinged support. For hinged support, just check it here. I'll give you hint also. For roller support, DOF is 2. For hinged support, DOF is 1. Now tell me. What is the total DOF for the given structure? Students, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Just tell me, what is the total DOF for this given structure?
3, sir.
Very good, very good, very good. 3. So for this is 1 and this is 2. So DOF for this given structure is 3. So by using a formula also, we can, by using this formulation also, we can able to calculate. So DK is equal to 3J-R. So number of joints is 2, R is 3, 6-3, it is 3. So we can able to calculate this also. But here, what is axial strains? By considering axial strains, what is meant by axial strains? Axial strain ante. So along with this deformation, this member may also elongate or contract because of the deformation of the supports. If you are considering the axial strains also, then this is the formula. If you are neglecting the axial strain, what is axial strain? Delta is equal to PL by. How to calculate strain? Change in length by?
Delta to PL by A is your formula.
So delta L PL by A. What is strain? Is it?
Change in length by original length.
Okay. So this P by A is the axial strain. So axial strains under now. So neglecting axial strain. So if you consider the axial strain, then degree of kinematic inductance is 3. If you are considering axial strain, degree of kinematic inductance is 3. If you are neglecting axial strains neglect cheyalante endi PL P by A neglect cheyali. So P by A depends upon what factor? P by A depends upon the number of members. Ippudu any number of members unte anni P by A values vastayi. Kabatti what we need to do, we need to deduct number of members from this equation. So final equation, if you neglect the axial strains, so degree of kinematic inductance will be, degree of kinematic inductance will be So degree of kinematic indeterminacy will be, I'll write here. If you are neglecting axial strains, then the degree of kinematic indeterminacy will be dk is equal to 3j minus r minus m. So this is the formula. 3j minus r అనేది మామూలుగా మనం నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ మెంబర్స్ కూడా డిడక్ట్ చేసుకుంటే మనకు వచ్చేసి ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నెగ్లెక్టింగ్ యాక్సియల్ స్ట్రెయిన్ సో దిస్ ఇది. సో సమ్ టైమ్స్ హీ మే ఆస్క్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నెగ్లెక్టింగ్ యాక్సియల్ స్ట్రెయిన్స్ దెన్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద డిగ్రీ ఆఫ్ కైనమెటిక్ ఇండక్టెన్సీ అంటాడు. ఇన్ ద సిచ్యువేషన్ వీ నీడ్ టు యూస్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా. ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ కన్సిడరింగ్ యాక్సియల్ స్ట్రెయిన్స్ ఆల్సో అని అనుకోండి, దెన్ యూ నీడ్ టు యూస్ ఓన్లీ అప్ టు దిస్ పోర్షన్. మెన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ మెంబర్స్ మనం డిడక్ట్ చేయాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. So try to remember this thing, students. Okay, na? E formula nunchi manam number of members kuda diseste we are going to neglecting the axial strains. Ikkada endante just minus common isukunnadu kabatti m plus r ani vachindi ikkada. Just to take minus common and just automatically plus vachestadu formula 3j minus m plus r. So this is for plane members. For space frames, 6j minus r. If you are neglecting axial strains, then 6j minus m plus r. Students, formulas okay na? Is it okay for you? Remember, this is very, very important for your competitive examinations. Meeku AEE, AE, deputy surveyor, itlanti exams lo compulsory untayandi. One or two questions compulsory. Students, try to focus on these formulas. Very simple, try to focus on this. Up to now, is there any doubt, students?
No, sir.
Yeah, students. Okay, right. So this is related to the introduction to the kinematic indeterminacy of the structure. So we will going to solve a few of the problems in the next class. After that, we will going to the degree of static indeterminacy also. The degree of static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy very, very important for your competitive examinations and for your interview purpose also. You may ask what is determinate structure, what is indeterminate structure. Okay, right, I'm just stopping the session. I'm going to stop recording the session.